First station, Jesus is condemned to death. Jesus just had one of the worst nights ever. Gets betrayed by one of his friends, arrested, tortured, and now he is condemned to death by the people he has cured, helped, and served. Oftentimes, we do not feel like doing hard things. We get lazy. We have bad days. We don't want to wake up. Jesus did nothing wrong and was condemned to death. Do we ever thank him for that? Let's thank him right now by giving him our best each day with all our effort.
Translation: Jesus carries his cross. Not only is Jesus given the death penalty, he also has to be publicly humiliated by carrying the piece of wood he will be nailed to, and yet he does it willingly. He embraces the cross. He is determined to do God's will. He is determined to show us that he is willing to suffer anything for us. How many times do we do things truly doing it for others? Let's embrace the challenge, the difficulty, the fatigue. Like Jesus embraced his cross, let's be stronger for each other. Let's get stronger so we can serve better.
Third station, Jesus falls for the first time. Jesus has lost a lot of blood. He was nearly whipped to death, had a crown of thorns shoved and beat into his skull. And he is exhausted. He falls, we fall many times as well. We fall as short of our goals at times. We have disappointments, discouragements, and we have doubts. Jesus went through this as well, but he didn't quit. He fell, but he got up. Let's show that same commitment. Let's never give up on ourselves or each other.
Station 4, Jesus meets his mother. Mary was doing everything she could to support, encourage, inspire, uplift her son in the midst of all the suffering. She was the perfect support for him, just as she had been his whole life. During our lives, we should be consistently looking for ways to encourage one another. The more we are focused on lifting others up, the less we are trapped in our own troubles. Let's make sure that every day we are improving in our level of encouragement, motivation, and communication.
Fifth station. Simon of Cyrene helps Jesus carry his cross. Simon did not want to help Jesus carry his cross. He didn't know him. Do we treat some people the same way? We are willing to encourage and challenge some, the ones we are close with, but the others who we don't know as well, not so much. But once Simon began to help Jesus, he grew to know him, respect him, and love him. Let's build true camaraderie in our lives with everyone. One team, one heart, one purpose.
Sixth station, Veronica wipes the face of Jesus. With angry, drunk soldiers surrounding a man they are en route to nail to a cross, one extremely courageous, bold, brave woman risks her life and her reputation by wiping Jesus' face with her cloth. She wanted to help in some small way, and nothing was going to stop her. How often do we give in to our fears of what others might say or do? Are we afraid of doing our best? Are we afraid of challenging others to do better, to strive harder for perfection? May we imitate the bold courage of Veronica and let nothing hold us back from helping others get better.
Seventh station, Jesus falls for the second time. Even after Simon comes to help him, Jesus still falls again. Perseverance is agonizingly difficult at times. Don't let falls, failures, or embarrassment stop you. Imitate Jesus on his way to Calvary. He fell down again and again, and every time he caught back up. He would fulfill his mission, period. Let's persevere. Let's fulfill our mission.
Eighth station, Jesus meets the woman of Jerusalem. Jesus is being marched to his death, and he still takes time to encourage others. He is selfless. He is all about others. He is all about us. Who do we work out for? Ourselves or others? Let's imitate our Lord and get louder in here. Let's encourage one another. Cowards get quiet in the face of adversity. Leaders get louder.
Station 9. Jesus falls for the third time. And another fall. We've all been through this. We want to achieve a personal best, break a record, accomplish a goal, see improvement, and we fail. Jesus knows exactly what we are going through, but Jesus was relentless. He always got back up. Jesus teaches us to forget about the failures and focus on the finish. Let's be relentless.
Station 10, Jesus' clothes are taken away. Betrayed, arrested, spit on, jailed, slapped, scourged, crowned with thorns, condemned, forced to carry a cross, and now stripped in public. If we ever think that our life is hard, that we have it tough, just think about Jesus in this moment. Jesus' toughness never let anyone tell you that Jesus wasn't tough. With the blink of an eye, he could have destroyed every one of his torturers, yet he took it because he wanted you to be able to look at him when your life got rough and know that he is with you. And with him, you can conquer anything.
Eleventh station, Jesus is nailed to the cross. We should offer up to God all our sufferings, all of our tears, all our difficulties. We should offer them up and make them into prayers. Every day should be a prayer that we are offering up to God for others. What do we sacrifice? That's what Jesus' crucifixion was all about, offering himself up for us, a sacrifice.
Twelfth station, Jesus dies on the cross. Was anyone more passionate or more dedicated than Jesus? He gave everything. He gave his life for you.
Thirteenth station, Jesus is taken down from the cross. While Jesus was hanging in agony on the cross, Mary Magdalene, and John were there for him. They did not abandon him. Jesus could count on them. They were loyal. Are you loyal? Can everyone count on you to be there for them when adversity hits?
14th station, Jesus is placed in the tomb. Jesus' passion and death were not the end. It was only the beginning. He did rise from the dead and changed everything. In him, we are renewed, given hope, and strengthened. May our struggles, tears, and pain give us the confidence to know that we can conquer anything.